Hi there. Today on Typical Books, I've got a little tiny haul and a couple of books that are coming out for December. So before I get to the new releases that are Horror Writers Association books, there's only three of them right now because it's so early in the month. I ended up picking up a couple books and I just thought that the price was the real news here. The Wastelands by Stephen King, featuring Charlie the Choo Choo, quite famously, is that paperback that I had originally read as a kid. I'm missing part two now because I haven't read the Dark Tower series in a very long time. So I thought I'd pick up The Gunslinger, and this The Drawing of the Three is going to be coming up next. And I'll pick up as many of the books as I can find used. This was $1.99, and it's in really, really good condition. It looks like it's only been read once, if ever at all. The other one, Dan Wells, I Am Not a Serial Killer. Excellent film, excellent price. It was 99 cents. It's in really good condition. And oddly, I had found this in the craft section of a thrift store. So I'd looked through the books and I picked up some wonderful finds. And then I found this. Incidentally, what I'd found is Great Expectations and Oliver Twist in these wonderful little hardcovers. They were $2.99 a piece. Not horror, so I'm not going to dwell on them, but they are on my Instagram. So I'm not a serial killer. This I wanted to almost lump into my nonfiction November reading, but it's going to come in December somewhere among the Stephen Graham Jones book and some other books that I'm planning on reading that have a winterier theme. So there are only three new releases to be listed right now. There's a few more that are more closer to the end of the month that I don't want to talk about yet because they're only in pre-order, or they're going to be in pre-order. They're going to be in pre-order for a while, and I'm hoping that I'll do another video or two. So at least I'll do a late December wrap-up as far as the new releases, and maybe a mid-December depending on how many come in. It is that quiet time. It's heading into that January slump that people are used to in film. It happens in books too. There are a lot of stocking stuffers on your shelves right now. We know this. We're doing Christmas shopping, I suppose, already. So those are already on the shelves. Right now it is sort of a reset time for publishing as far as I've gathered. I'm no publishing professional, but it seems to me that there is a break. And it's a break while people are doing things like National Novel Writing Month that just wrapped up. So congratulations to a lot of people that finished. And I've been following a lot of our fellow writers and readers here on YouTube that do post their NaNoWriMo progress. So wow, congratulations everyone who participated in that, whether you achieved it or not. You know, I think it's just noble to have taken up that race. So without further ado, here are a few books that are out. Some are out already. Collective Darkness, a horror anthology, and this is edited by Elizabeth Suggs, Brandon Prows, and Jonathan Reddoch, and it features stories by them and others. So this comes from Collective Tales Publishing and editing me. As a child, did you hide under your blankets when you were scared? After reading some of the scariest stories from new and up-and-coming authors, we won't blame you if you start hiding again. Take a journey with us into the twisted mind of horror. Collective Darkness isn't for the faint of heart. Read if you dare. I like the cover of this. I like the font of this. It looks a lot like a font that I always like, a Lolita Scorned. I'm not sure what font they use, and I don't know why I'm so hung up on fonts, but I think it's a cool looking cover, and it's refreshing because so many of our horror covers do have black spines and red writing and things like that. This is kind of refreshing. The Devils Do. Nothing is Ever as It Seems, Volume 1. Edited by Adam Messer, Valhalla Books. This has various authors and a lot of Horror Writers Association authors in particular. Because the one thing you will notice that a lot of these collections feature authors that are not under the umbrella of the HWA, and that's perfectly fine. There's going to be an editor or something, a publicist that is a member that can promote these books where I get them from, on the list that they send to the new releases page. So this is from Valhalla Books and it is out now. Nothing is ever as it seems. Ill-begotten wealth, fame, and glory come at a high price. Featuring award-winning authors and HWA members, The Devil's Do offers enthralling horror stories of underhanded deals gone awry. I like the cover of that one too. Devilish, don't you think? And this one will be of interest to the Stephen King fans in the crowd. Excavating Stephen King, a Darwinist Hermeneutic Study of the Fiction by James Arthur Anderson. This comes from Lexington and Rowman and Littlefield, and it is out in a week. I'm sure that it can be under pre-order. A lot of things that are coming up are in pre-order right now. Excavating Stephen King. Now, this combines approaches from science and literary theory to examine the canon of Stephen King's fiction work in a single critical study. He has devised a concept of Darwinist hermeneutics, and I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that correctly, as a critical tool to combine evolutionary psychology, neuroscience, biology, and literary Darwinism with other more conventional critical theory, including structuralism, narratology, semiotics, and linguistic analysis. I'm very interested in the semiotics as far as Stephen King goes, because he does rely on so many archetypal tropes and imprints burnt into our collective history, I believe. And that is where he gets his fears and scary from. And it's going beyond like what scared you as a child. You know, he can drill down to how the shape of eyes reflected in things that he's describing in the landscapes terrify you and you can't put your finger on why. And I'm very interested to know what the take is on a semiotician about how much he knew going into this, or how much of this is organic, just him writing as a human on Earth. Using this theory, Anderson examines King's works in terms of archetypes and mythology, human universals, affective emotions, and the organization of story to create maximum suspense. You could make the argument that his books are so long, there's no room for suspense anymore. You want suspense in short, sharp little injections, I think, but hey, who knows? This method brings new insights into King's stories and broader implications for storytelling as a whole. Now, that was a very long summary. That length of summary isn't normally what ends up in the newsletter, but I thought it would serve well here because many of us are Stephen King fans. And it would do a disservice to just summarize this man's work so briefly, right? Because it does warrant a little more explanation as to why somebody would take a Darwinist approach to Stephen King's fiction. But there you have it. Those are books coming up for the beginning of December. Most of them are already out, except one that's coming out in a week. Hopefully I'll have another video like this coming up soon as we traverse the slump of the beginning of winter or beach season, depending on where you're from. So thank you very much for watching. If you're going to pick up any of these reads, or if you already own some of the books that I mentioned, let me know in the comments, and have a nooky, spooky day.